Yo's up, guys, it's Godito here, and today we're gonna be playing Modern Warfare 2 Rust Zombies. Now, this is basically the multiplayer map Rust from Modern Warfare 2. It's now been zombified basically, and it has like the models of the zombies are actually from Buried, and I think it has about every No, not every single perk, but quite a handful of perks, I must say. As you can see, guys, we have Widow's Wine right here, which I'm surprised they were even able to, get that all working in there. I didn't think they would. And apparently you start off with 0 points, which, to be honest, that kind of sucks, but gotta deal with it because it's kiss some zombies. So yeah, this is just gonna be a playthrough, like my first official playthrough of a custom zombies map. So yeah, and hopefully we do good because actually, here's the thing about this map. This map is insanely easy. What I mean by this is, what I mean is. By this being easy is the box never moves. There's no other box spots. If you're playing with other people, you can camp up there. Yes, you can actually go up there. I'll show you. See? You can actually go up here, and if you're playing with a couple other people, zombies will come over here, zombies will come through the ladder, and zombies will come over there, right through here. Yeah, and when you play with people, this is insanely hectic, but we're not gonna do that because we're playing solo, and we're supposed and basically how you train is you train throughout the entire map. That's how it really works. And also, here's the Bible ending, which I think we'll be able to get. I think we'll be able to get it. All right, let me find the zombie, and we'll go. Whoa, you just came out of nowhere. Yeah, we start off with the USP Tactical, probably one of the most weakest pistols in Modern Warfare. Hold on, I'm just scratching my eye. Whew. Okay. So yeah, as you can see, already by round two, they are getting really fast. That's because this map is supposed to be very, fast-paced, and I like that. Keeps the. Let's pretend that never happened. Hold on. I'm gonna go ahead and pretend that never happened. All right. So hold up. Grab my mouse. Right. So yeah, let's pretend that never happened. So you already know the drill. So yeah. Oh yeah, here's a jug. Here's a electric cherry. Speed cola. Quick revive right about there. Let's kill these zombies real quick. And again, I do not know how this is gonna look once this is uploaded. I mean, I'm probably gonna know because I'm gonna edit the damn thing. But yeah, I'm just gonna cut out the boring parts. And yeah. Oh, and sometimes zombies will bounce up in that particular spot, but it's no worries. You can just kill them right from here. It's that simple. And I'm about to die yet again. That was pretty cool. Not really. What a noob move. Get destroyed, get destroyed. All right, so for my strategy of this map, I usually like to go with a random weapon, aka the mystery box. There is no wall buyable weapons, which is kind of a shame because I don't want to keep, playing this map and hope for a good weapon and hope for max ammos and whatnot. So you're gonna have to depend on the box for pretty much the majority, for pretty much the entire game of Rut. Sorry about that. Disconnected yet again, but no worries, no worries. I'll yeah. All right, so yeah, for my strategy, I just like to go ahead and buy a random weapon because that's the your stockpile of weapons is basically gonna be dependent on the box because there are no wall buys, like I said. So you're gonna have to depend on the box for it for your ammunition. Alrighty, let's go hit from the box. Quickly, quickly. Ranger, this is basically the Olympia. Oh, this thing sucks. I mean, it kind of wrecks for now, but this thing, no, it's not a very good weapon to have. And also, by the way, the most powerful weapon, get this, the most powerful weapon in this game is snipers. You heard me right, snipers. And you might be asking yourself, why snipers? Well, because it's Modern Warfare 2. Everyone uses this map to quickscope. So, there really, it would make sense for this map's powerful weapon to be snipers. And I don't think there's any wonder weapons in this map. I haven't seen at least. Yeah, we might not see any wonder weapons. Well, I don't know if there is any wonder weapons at all. Let me just get rid of this zombie, these zombies. Alrighty then. Alright, let's just no, not yet, not yet. Alright, let's just keep going. This zombie still likes to jump up and down. Let's just get the nuke, why not? Alright, so we're just gonna hit the box one more time, hope for a good weapon that we can, Would you look at that? I got the intervention. One of the best snipers in Modern Warfare 2. Can you just give me a point gun for Beck's sake, game? Well, I do love the Desert Eagle, so can't complain about that, I guess. I've always wanted to have the Desert Eagle stuff. It's pretty cool stuff. No! Oh my god, clutch, clutch, clutch. Clutch, clutch. Can we clutch this? Alright, let's snipe these fools. Nope. Knifing in this map is kind of risky, so I really recommend you play this map with a controller. Or if you're really good with PC controls, just be able to, back away. Perfect, perfect. And we got a max ammo as well. Alright, I don't want the sniper just because of the fact that, not gonna be a good thing to use while training. Just saying. Oh, the Beretta. Isn't this called a Rafika? I think it's called a Rafika. Oh, it's a three-burst rifle, just like the, B23R. I mean, I guess it gives you points. I don't know. I mean, the bullets, the kind of reminiscent of, tiny BB bullets at the most. So that's what these things, that's what this gun feels like. I feel like I'm shooting a BB gun. I guess it'll do for now. No! Oh my god, I really thought I was gonna die there. Alright, so we're gonna get Jug. Because that's what we need. Alright, let's leave these two. But I mean. Wait. Let's get rid of these. Cool. Alright, let's go get Jug. Please. Ah, man, I really thought we were gonna have enough points to pack. Not pack a punch. Hold up, there's something under my feet. It's kind of bothering me right now. Okay, good. Can we siphon off a couple points? I don't think so. Nope, not even the closest. Alright, you know what? Let's just go get Crocovite while we're at it. Just because we need it for our survival. And yes, I have played this map a lot because, like I said before, it is one of the most easiest maps ever. Like, when you know your way around this map and you know what to and you know what your strategy is, you can easily get to round 30 in like I'd say at least an hour. Alright, I need to get this double points. Don't wanna get the insta kill just yet. Well, I'm just gonna ignore the insta kill, I guess. I need to siphon off as much points as I possibly can because, oh my god, I'd be damned if I don't have enough points to even hit the box. Okay. We're gaining some points up in here. Pretty cool. All right. Think we're gonna grab a nuke just now. Nah, I don't want the nuke. I like that cover smiley dead face thing. I don't need this. I need a gun. Thank you. This is what I'm looking for. All right. One second, guys. Sorry about that. If you hear chewing noises, that's because I'm eating. I know it's rude to talk while you're eating, but, that was good. I mean the, BLT, by the way. Alright, this is going well. And if you think you're up to the challenge, you can try and train in small pla in small places like these. And what I usually like to do after I feel like there's quite literally no other way I can go, I go over here and then that's where I kill them. Whoa. Now, this version of the FAMAS is a burst, so it's not like fully automatic. Which is a shame. Would have been nice. But, you know. It's how it is. So, yeah, every Sunday, I'm gonna put out a gameplay of a custom map. Maybe with a friend or with myself. But, yeah. And by the way, PhD is in this map as you already saw, I think. Come on. All right, we got 5,000 points. That's amazing right there. Right, hold on. Had to eat. So let's get ourselves this beet cola. I like to do my perks in the order of this. It just feels natural. The original four perks. Like I said, if you're feeling up to the challenge, try and train in this little spot right here. It's a little risky, but if you think you can pull it off, then go for it, I'd say. I say because really, this is really easy if you think about it, 'cause I mean, it's like even though the map seems tight, it's really not because you have to make the best of it by using the spaces they give you. So, you know, yeah. Classic zombie philosophy. When does it ever go wrong? Not all the time, but you know what I mean. Jeez, this thing has a lot of recoil. Well, that's what I expect from a 50-caliber handgun. Is it 50-caliber? Yeah, it's 50-caliber. I thought I was gonna get all of them within one shot. Let's try for another weapon. I mean, I kinda don't want this. Oh, guys, we just got one of the most OP weapons in this map, the AA-12. And if we can get the other OP weapon, the AUG or the AUG, we are set. What's this? ACR. Okay, you know what? I'll stick with this. I'll stick with this. But the AA-12, guys, you guys don't even know how good of a weapon this actually is right now. This is really, really, really good. And when you pack a punch this thing, you are an unstoppable. You are a force to be reckoned with. No one can touch you with this weapon. Just, I'm so glad I got this. Oh my god. Now, I'm gonna stop it in the box because I need to, you know, gain some points for my perks. And yeah, I mean that's really the goal of this, to get to a high round and to also get the perks that I want. I'm not gonna get who's who just because of the facts. Just because of the fact that that perk is really, really bad and it's useless as well. So there's really no point in trying to get it, trying to use it at all. Yeah, my game just literally froze a frame there for a second, but thank God it's nothing serious. But yeah, what you guys just saw there, who's who, I am not getting you. You are by far one of the worst perk, one of the worst perks in Call of Duty history. I don't know why Treyarch decided to make you, but something must have been going on behind the scenes, I swear. So I'm sorry if you're not hearing any sound. That's because I turned it off just to, you know, focus and not have, you know, sound in the background. But, yeah. I mean, does it really matter if I have sound anyway? Sorry about that. Gotta eat food. Future me, you better edit all this stuff out. Me eating. When you hold this thing down, look at how many of these fools die. Oh my god. Oh, I need that. Double points, baby. Oh shit. Whew. Oh my god, I thought that was the end of me right there. See, these map creators are getting clever, you know? I think I know the reason why the map creator decided to make this so fast-paced, especially at round 2. It's because they want to make this as hard as possible, when really, it's actually kind of easy. So, yeah. Damn. See, can you guys see how much things you can accomplish with this gun? The AA-12. This is like the... You know what? In my book, I consider that a wonder weapon. I don't care. I don't care what any of you say. This is a wonder weapon in my book. None of you can say so otherwise. Huh! Clutch! Alright, go back around. Bring it around town. Like I... Wait, what? What was I saying? Oh. Yeah, as you can clearly see, guys, I am a professional at training zombies. It took me, not gonna lie, quite literally months of preparation to train for Black Ops 3, mainly because I knew it wouldn't have a difficulty mode, so I wouldn't, you know, cheat my way, you know, like I did in Black Ops 2, but... Essentially, I've mastered the art of herding slash training, and to be honest, it feels really good. Feels good to just be, you know, be a master at something. Especially in a tight area like this, some people would not be able to train in this type of area, but look at me, I'm making the best out of it. Alright, hold up. Sorry about that. Alright. So yeah, I'm gonna try and save up as much points as possible. Then we're gonna go ahead and buy our perks. And pack a punch, hopefully. I can't wait to show you guys all the other maps on next Sunday. Well, not all the other maps, but I do have a very unique map to show you guys, and I hope you'll find it somehow intriguing in a way. Oh my god! Yo. Oh my god, I was gonna die there. Alrighty, get wrecked. Alright, buy this electric cherry because this actually helps you really like a lot. Stamina up. Run a lot more fast. With his wine. Because it can protect me. Alrighty, man. Let's go. I'm ripping these guys a new asshole right now. I'm making a bunch of crawlers too, so yeah. You see how much points Widow's Wine gives you? Like, it literally siphons off points off the zombies when they're like frozen and stuff, which is so good. Alright, hold up, guys. Yeah, hearing me eat must be very disgusting for you guys, isn't it? Probably is. But for the little percentage of you guys, it must make you very hungry, I'd say. What if it does? Alright, AA 12! Alright, we're gonna get all of our perks. The ones that I need anyway. And we're gonna make a last stand. Actually, we're not gonna get Mule Kick because you don't need that. We don't need that. Not now at least. Scared, Deadshot, Daiquiri. You know, why not? You know? I mean, I'm not really a big fan of Deadshot Daiquiri, but I'll get it just for the sake of, getting it. Jeez. Get destroyed. Look at that. Look at that pure annihilation right there. Please don't fall. Mantle over by PhD Flopper. Alright, let's make our last stand here, guys. Yeah. No! Oh wait, I have PhD Flopper. What am I being so panicked for? Let's go back up here. Come on, guys, you're way too slow. And I'm too stupid. Wait a second. I'm a genius. I think I just found a glitch spot. Never mind, no, I didn't. Alright, thank God I had PhD Flopper because if I didn't, oh my God, the damage would have been real. The damage would have been real. But I was really, like, excited there for a moment because I thought I had found a glitch spot and I thought I could exploit this, but unfortunately, they found a way to destroy me. Make a last stand here, boys. Come on. Huh? He just paused there for a moment, like, am I really gonna attack him? Yes, I'm gonna attack him. Last stand! Gonna try not to fall off of here. Come on, come on, come at me. All right. Come on. Oh no, out of ammo. Out of. No! I went down! Ah, man, I died. Well, that was a good one, guys. I hope you enjoyed this gameplay, and if you did, feel free to drop a like. Maybe even subscribe, but you know, that's entirely up to you. If you don't like me, you don't like me, okay? Sometimes I don't even like myself. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay, and I will see all of you later. Now, let me just go ahead and actually exit this. So, yeah. Later, guys.